In this sports Photoshop tutorial, you're going to learn how to do this thumbnail design for the NBA Finals. The very first thing that we're going to do is create our document. If you guys already know how to do this, you can skip ahead in the video. 132 is when I really start breaking down the design. So what you're going to do is go up to File, New, and you want to change your file size to 1280 by 720. This is the default thumbnail size for YouTube. I also make the switch to RGB, and I keep my bitrate around 8. All right. Now that we have our document created, let's add some players to it. There's two ways that you can do this. The first is my personal preference, and that's just clicking and dragging from Google. The other way is to right click or control click on your image, go to save image as, and then save it to your desktop. Then we can go ahead and go to file, place embedded, and we can find our image. The image of Steph Curry has a little bit of white in the background, as you guys can see. So now let's learn how to cut that out. My personal preference and the quickest way to do this is to go to the quick selection tool on the toolbar on the left hand side. And what we're going to do is we're going to go up to select subject. Now what this does is it gives it a rough outline around your image. And now you can hit the mask button on the bottom right hand corner. And what that's going to do is cut out all of that white around it. So now you're just going to be left with your subject. Alright, let's get to the fun part of this video, the actual design process. So stick with me here, you're not going to miss any of this stuff, it's really good. So let's do the background first. So create two rectangles by clicking and dragging using the rectangle tool on the left hand side. You're going to want to do this twice, and you can fill them with whatever color you want, because we're going to fill it later with the actual logo color. Alright, next, click and drag any logos off of Google Images. This is very, very important. We're going to match the color from our logos to our rectangles. All right, with our rectangle layer selected, go up to the fill button and hit this color box here. And now you can sample the logo with the eyedropper tool. Next, let's put our logos inside the rectangles. You can do this by control clicking the logo layer and then going up to create clipping mask. Let's lower the opacity of our logos so they're kind of hiding in the background. This can be done by just moving this slider closer to zero. What really makes this design great is this gold frame that's in the middle of the design. So start by creating three rectangles. All of the rectangles need to overlap one another, so there's no space in between. You're eventually going to merge them together to create one big rectangle. Once you have all your rectangles created, we want to get rid of this black outline on the rectangles. This can be done by clicking your object and hitting stroke and selecting the option with the red line through it. You're going to want to do that for all three rectangles. Now we want to merge these rectangles together. This can be done by clicking on the third rectangle and holding shift and then clicking on the first rectangle. Then control click and we're going to merge our shapes together. Next, go on Google Images and find a gold PNG that looks similar to this one and place it over top of your merged rectangle. Control click and create a clipping mask. If you guys want this gold PNG that I'm using, DM me on Instagram. The first 100 subscribers to DM me, I'm gonna give you all the assets, including the font and the gold PNG. So just let me know on Instagram. I appreciate all your support. If you have those notifications turned on, you're gonna be one of the first 100 subscribers. So please just DM me, I got you. Next, we're gonna create some more shapes to create this gold trim around the outside. This part is self-explanatory, but once you're finished, it should look something like this. All right, now it's time to add our text. I'm using the text tungsten condensed. Like I mentioned earlier, if you want it, DM me on Instagram, first 100 subs, you guys got it for free. I decided to give it a slight tilt, and this can be done by control clicking on the text and going to skew. Once you've hit skew, you can move the right hand corner to the right and it creates this effect. You can then press Command J on your text to duplicate the layer. All right, after resizing our text, we're starting to look like an NBA graphic designer. This is one of the best tips I've gotten as a graphic designer, so stick with me, you're not gonna wanna miss this one. If you look at our NBA Finals logo, it has a black and gold background, so you can't just go to quick selection and go up to select subject and do it that way. It doesn't mask it out correctly. So what you can do is double click on your layer Now, under blending options, you're going to move the slider to the right. What this does is it gets rid of anything that shade of black and darker. But what you can see is it actually gets rid of the blue that is on the NBA logo. So you're going to have to duplicate your logo and you're going to mask out everything but that NBA sign. And so I did the same thing for the trophy because the trophy had a little bit of black in it as well. So the blending options was actually getting rid of that part of the trophy as well. All right, after we've resized our logos, let's move on to my favorite part of this design, the gold texts. So let me show you how this was done. First, you're gonna click on the bottom text layer, then press Command and click on the top text layer, and you're gonna convert this into a smart object. Next, find that same piece of gold that we used before, and we're gonna hit Command J to duplicate it. Next, drag that gold layer above your text layer that you just converted to a smart object, and then Control click and hit Clipping Mask. What this will do is put it inside of your text. All right, this is the most important part of the video. We're gonna learn how to take this and turn it into something more detailed and vibrant like this. First, click your player layer and head up to Camera Raw Filter. Once we're in Camera Raw Filter, you want to adjust your clarity and texture. I also made a couple other adjustments. You can always go back through the video and duplicate what I did. I also like to play with saturation to make sure your player image pops. I did the same exact adjustments for Steph Curry. Shadows. First, create a layer directly behind your players. Next, go up and click the paintbrush on the toolbar on the left-hand side. Choose black and you're going to paint on dark shadows behind your two players. This is done so they stand out in the thumbnail and almost pop. Once you've done that, let's create a layer above our players and paint shadows in the front of the design. You can always lower the opacity of any shadows that you create by moving that slider that says opacity closer to zero. And once you've done that, you're done. If you enjoyed this video, please feel free to drop a like for me. It really means a lot to me and it helps the channel grow. And it shows that you guys like this type of video. Also, click that subscribe button. I'm dropping a new tutorial every single Monday. So stay tuned and keep those notifications on so you don't miss any of the giveaways I do in every video. And that's it, man. Stay great and I'll see y'all in the next tutorial.